Our earlier story on International Press Freedom Day, and we have the lead editor, journalism.ng, Oba Adeoye, joining me at this point. Thank you very much for sticking around, Oba Adeoye. You have been in the media for a very long time. You've practiced journalism here and all around the world. Reporters Without Borders are saying that Nigeria is one of West Africa's most dangerous and difficult countries for journalists. React to that.
Of course, I think that statement captures the reality on ground, because if you look at the state of press freedom in Nigeria today, you see a plethora of issues, hanging around that particular concept, as in the concept of the freedom of expression by the media, which of course is adequately guaranteed by Section 39 of Section 1 of the Federal Republic, of the Constitution of the Federal Republic. I'm talking about the 1999 Constitution. But if you look at the prevailing situation in the country, you realize that press freedom is not press freedom in Nigeria, so to say, as a number of issues are responsible for dragging back that freedom of expression by the media. One of them is secrecy. You know that as Africans, we grew up, or we have this tendency of wanting to hold information, of wanting to keep information secret for just for the sake of keeping it secret. People in position of authority, people in position of government, over the years, you know, use that particular tool, the tool of secrecy, to protect themselves, to protect certain information from getting to the public. It's a major issue. Secrecy is the big issue, despite the fact that some years back, former President Goodluck Jonathan assented to the Freedom of Information Act that later became a law. It has not really done much in really helping press freedom in Nigeria. We still have elements of the Official Secret Act playing out, especially with public officials, public servants, and the rest of them. Of course, some of us are making use of that law, but again, we still have a big problem ensuring that the law works as intended.
All right, looking at it, all you have said, now the media is regarded as the fourth estate of the realm. How far can we go? What can we do, or what can be done to ensure that the industry, the journalism profession, is free to do its job and not face the consequences of its actions?
Okay, I think some months back, the House of Representatives came up with an idea of trying to set like a standard for qualification for anyone who wants to practice journalism in Nigeria. I think there is need for us to do that. A lot of entrants who are accidental journalists right now, who of course to the public they are journalists, but in the actual sense of it, they are accidental journalists. And the new media is not helping matters. With some clicks of the mouse on the internet, you end up having your own news website up and running, and you're free to push out all sorts of information without any form of regulation. So there's need to have a very good system of regulation on ground. I'm not talking about the kind of regulation that people in government are talking about. I'm talking about self-regulation of the media by the media itself. It's a very big problem. A lot of the information and misinformation are going on the internet right now, which of course is not doing the society any good. Don't forget that the theme for this year's World Press Freedom Day is information as a public good, as pushed by UNESCO. So many information that are coming out as journalistic efforts are really not doing the society anything good. In other parts of the world, the world of journalism is gradually tilting towards a focus on solutions journalism, solutions and advocacy journalism. How much of that have we been able to do in Nigeria as the press community? I believe so much in self-censorship, not necessarily government censorship this time around. And that would really help us to be our own watchdog. We watch society as the fourth arm of the realm. But who is watching us? Who is watching the watchdog? We really need to do something as regards that, and it must come from within.
How do we actually watch the watchdog now? How do we regulate, like you have called, the new media in all of this so that we do not have disinformation flying all around?
It's going to take a lot of advocacy. I believe so much in advocacy, and much more advocacy, because you cannot force anybody to join any organization or any assembly without their own volition. So it's going to take a lot of advocacy to be led by the likes of maybe the Nigerian Guild of Editors, NGE, the NUJ. All of these associations or guilds are busy doing some other things apart from what we should be doing right now. So we need to roll up our sleeves and ensure that we engage more with journalists across board, across platforms, and of course across the nation, to see how we can come together and ensure that our responsibility as enunciated in Section 39 subsection 1 of the 1999 Constitution is done, and is done adequately well. So it's going to come from within, and until we start doing it from within, nobody's going to do it for us. Right. If you check the legal profession, you check the doctors, those in the medical world, you see that most of these regulations, most of these things are done from within. Of course, it's little support from without, that's from the government and by way of legislation and what have you, but the bulk of them will come from within. And you know, by the time we start doing that, we know that it's no longer business as usual, especially for those smart guys on the internet. Like sometimes during the week, I was at a training session, a workshop session organized by the Nigerian Guild of Investigative Journalists in Lagos. And part of the issues we discussed was that it's high time we started bringing ourselves together in clusters, in groups, in associations, in guilds, and trying to look at issues that affect us, and trying to look at issues that will help us in delivering what is expected of us to do as the press society generally in Nigeria.
All right, lead editor, journalism.ng, Obadioye, thank you so much for talking to us.